Now, after recording the application for the first time, that was my sample application, let us see that what is the meaning of the scripts which they have recorded. What exactly is the place that is known as active screen, what it says. So let us see that. If in this previous video I've recorded the scripts, okay, I wanted to record agent name, password and OK button, these three steps, okay, when I log in, after login I want to close the application. So these are the steps which are generated. So if you observe here, that is given as agent name, password and I'll say as OK button and this is close. So one step, second step, third step and the fourth step. These four steps should be available. But apart from that, if you see, there are some steps which are given which are not required. Okay, that is activate the window, move from this location to that location. So what I'll do is I'll reduce my steps by removing this unwanted steps here. Okay, so I'll just remove that, select the steps, remove that, and I'll select this last step and I'll remove that. So whatever actions I perform, okay, so any actions if I perform on the application, if I click on that, if I drag and drop that, I'm trying to do some actions with the application. Everything will be recorded into your editor. Okay, this area is known as editor part. So let us see in detail. Okay, so if I keep my cursor on the first line, okay, it says this is the username, okay, in the active screen, I mean the active screen tab, and if you see that is highlighted in the pink color. So it says right now you're performing something on this particular text box, okay. So if I click on the second line, it says right now you're working on this password text box. So it says this WP edit, WPF edit and the password. Okay, if I click on this third one, it says you're working on this OK button. So why this is very useful, if you're a manual tester, you will understand the pain. So if you want to, you found out the defect at any step, you have to create a snapshot. But UFT will do a snapshot automatically for you in the active screen itself. So you can understand which line you're working from this snapshot itself, right? And the last step, let's see, if I click on this close button, okay, it's not there. So, but it says for the OK button, it is working fine. Okay, now what exactly is the meaning? I'll try to explain you here. So it says, what is the meaning of this WPF window? Okay, HP MyFlight sample application dot. So what is HP MyFlight sample application? It is written in the red color. So let's see, HP MyFlight sample application. The name is unique. Okay, so that is the name of the application. And that is nothing but a window, or you can say as parent object name. So parent object name. So that is a parent object. This username is a child of this parent object name. Okay, parent object. So dot WPF edit agent name. So dot means, if you say dot, that means it's a child object. Okay, so username is a child object, password is a child object, OK button is a child object. So the parent is same for all of them, all the three objects. These are the child objects. After that, if you see dot set, that means you're doing some action. Dot click, that means you are doing some operation or actions on that particular object itself. So everything is mentioned in this place. So if you want to modify anything, let's say if you want to change, instead of John, you can type John 2 from here. Okay, it is nothing but an editor. John 2 will not work. Okay, J-O-H 2N will not work because it's not a valid name. So what I've done is, in this I've used valid credentials John and capital HP. Okay, so it will work fine. Now this is the place where you can edit, modify scripts. If you want to add for loops, if loop, everything, you can do it here. This place is known as active screen. So I hope you are able to understand active screen. People who know the coding part, for them it will be easy to understand. Okay, so it will be very easy to understand what is parent object, child object. Okay, but people who don't know the coding part, who are like coming from manual testing part to automation for the first time, there is a facility given for those people in this place, in the UFT. What is that? I'll just go to this place as view toolbar, and that is known as keyword view. So that is option known as keyword view. Okay, this one is the editor right now which you're working. If I want to jump from editor to other part, okay, if I click on this keyword view, this is specially for those people who have no knowledge about the coding. They're looking for the first time. So I'll just show you what exactly it is. Now it says my HP MyFlight sample application. Okay. And below that there are three objects which are given: agent name, password and OK. So if you observe, let's see the first column icon, it says that's a window. The pencil button means edit box. Again, there's a button given here, that's a OK button, the symbol is given. So based on the application objects, the icon changes. So that's a pencil button, that is means edit. Okay, now if you write a test case, usually that is steps to execute, click on this place, enter a username, enter password, click on OK button. So for them, people who are manual testers, for them you can see that's a documentation. enter John in the agent name edit box. Enter encrypted password in the password edit box. Click on OK button and so on. So if you are very good into test cases, you'll understand this very, very easily. So these are nothing but steps to execute. On which object? On this object. How do you execute the steps? By doing this operation: set secure, click or close. These are the things. You have a data column in the test case. What is that data column? That is a John and that's some password given. If you want, you can keep changing this data, right? You can just click on this and you can keep on changing the data. Right now we'll not go into that. Okay, so let us see that. If I click on this password, you see that is getting highlighted. If I click on this OK, this OK button is highlighted. From here I can conclude that this keyword view, this is the keyword view, is similar to editor. Okay, editor will be used by people who have the coding knowledge. Okay, and keyword view will be used for people who don't have knowledge of coding. But at the end, even a manual tester, he has to come back to the editor view. Okay, he has to write some coding part and so on. So that will be covered in the VB scripting part itself. So I hope you have able to understand what exactly are the scripts, the definition of the script, what they have generated, what is a keyword view, what is an editor view, and what is the active screen. And if you want to jump from keyword view to editor view, you have to just click on this view button. And then view menu bar, you have to click on this view button itself, view a menu bar, and you have to click on this editor button. So you can keep on jumping from editor to the keyword view itself. So I hope you have been able to understand, and that's all for this video.